So hello, welcome to Wildwood and welcome to our Chough talk. We'll be telling you a little bit about the Choughs here at Wildwood. So first of all, what on earth are Choughs? Well, they're a very unusual crow. Well, that's the simple way of summing them up. They belong to the corvid family of birds, which most people would know as the crow family, and they're one of Britain's rarest birds. By crow standards, they're fairly small. They're a little larger than a jackdaw, but smaller than a standard carrion crow. The beak is quite distinctive. It's fairly long, slender, and curved. Feathers are black, but most strikingly, the beak and the legs are bright red in colour. There are actually two different types of chough. The type we have here at Wildwood are the red-billed choughs, and their cousins are known as the alpine choughs. One of the big differences, alpine choughs have yellow beaks, not red. Red-billed choughs are found right the way across Europe and Asia. However, they are endangered in certain countries, including Britain. They're one of England's rarest birds, and they are definitely and undoubtedly the rarest corvid you find in Britain. By crow standards, choughs have a rather unusual lifestyle. In certain ways, they are sort of standard. They have the black plumage, they pair for life, and they are highly intelligent. One of the ways that they're unusual by corvid standards, they are sedentary. And that means that they stay in one place and they don't move around a lot. It's unusual for choughs to move more than 12 miles. The other odd thing is that they are specialist feeders. They have an unusually specialised diet. The giveaway is the beak, that long curved beak. This is designed for probing into soil, soft soil. In the summertime, they mainly eat insects and other creepy crawlies. In the wintertime, they'll also eat seeds, fruit and berries. Most corvids, most crows, tend to be generalists. They can take a wide range of foods and they don't specialise in any one thing. And this means that choughs are already potentially more at risk. We know from historical sources that choughs were widespread and fairly common in the Middle Ages. And their decline over the years has been due to several different reasons. First of all, they were strangely misunderstood birds. In medieval times, it was believed that they would steal grain. And this is because they were seen in the fields probing about in the soil. Sometimes they'd be seen taking insects from the bodies of newly dead animals. And unfortunately, people instantly thought, oh, they've killed that animal. Worst of all, strangest of all, they had a reputation for being arsonists. It was the genuine belief that these birds enjoyed setting fire to things. According to one source, choughs were an incendiary, thievish bird, often setting fire to houses and stealing and hiding small money. Another account states, sometimes it has stolen bits of firebrand or lighted candles and lodged them in stacks of corn and the thatch of barns and houses and set them alight. I should state, this is not true in any way, shape or form. The second problem for the choughs came in 1532. When King Henry VIII passed a law known as the Preservation of Grain Act. There'd been several bad harvests. There were food shortages. People were literally starving. And this law stated that any animal that was a threat to food supply or food sources was to be killed. It stated various animals that were a threat. It gave rewards, known as bounties, for people who killed and proved that they killed these animals, and it even imposed fines on villages that weren't killing the right number of vermin. Some of the animals might have had an effect. They include things like the red fox, and the crow, and the polecat. There are other animals that we wouldn't think of being a threat, like hedgehogs. In the Middle Ages, it was genuinely believed that hedgehogs sucked milk from cows, and if left to their own devices, could suck an entire dairy herd dry in a night. Again, this is not true. But the act also covered animals that really were no threat at all. Not just the choughs, but things like kingfishers and even adders. The Preservation of Grain Act was later reinforced by Elizabeth I in 1566, and it wasn't actually repealed as a law until the mid-18th century. However, the biggest decline in chough numbers came in the 18th and 19th centuries, and it seems to be linked to a change in land use. Choughs nest in craggy, inaccessible places, and this is so the eggs and the chicks are safe from predators. Favourite spots include sea cliffs, mountains, quarries, and ruined buildings. But they also need a patchwork of habitats close by so they can forage for food both for themselves and for their chicks. Most importantly, they need areas with short turf, with grass less than 5 centimetres in height. Short grass means that the chough can reach the soil to search for insects. And those insects will be further encouraged by animal dung. This meant that fields used for grazing animals like sheep, cattle, and horses were absolutely perfect for the choughs. Originally, if you had any fields at all, even if they were near the coast, you'd use them. But in the 18th and 19th century, that started to change. Coastal pasture fell out of use, more scrub started to grow, and the choughs couldn't reach the soil anymore. In most corvids, this would not be a problem, they'd move away. But as I mentioned earlier, choughs are sedentary, they stay in one spot. And that's one of the reasons why they went into such a rapid decline. The final nail in the chough's coffin came in the Victorian times, and it was very much almost a double whammy. Gamekeepers employed by stately homes and their estates would kill any animal they saw as being a threat to their pheasants, partridges, or grouse. And again, the chough is a crow, it must be bad. They were trapped, poisoned, and shot. At the same time, Victorians had a real mania for natural history collecting. Things like ferns, orchids, and birds' eggs. And the rarer a bird, the more prized its eggs would be. I have to state, collecting birds' eggs from the wild is now totally illegal. It cannot be done. There are major fines and even prison sentences handed out for people caught doing it. But unfortunately, these factors meant that by the mid-20th century, choughs were actually extinct in England. Today, we believe there are between 250 and 350 pairs of choughs in the whole of Britain. That's mainly on the Isle of Man, with 120 to 150 pairs, the coast of Wales, and the northwest coast of Northern Ireland. In 2001, after 10 years of habitat management and restoration, Paradise Park down in Cornwall tried the first reintroduction of choughs to Britain. Sadly, it did not succeed. However, in exactly the same year, wild choughs arrived. We know through looking at their DNA, they actually came from Ireland. They came down the coast of Wales. And because those habitats were now perfect for them, they stayed. We believe there are more than 100 choughs currently living wild down in Cornwall. In 2013, Jersey Zoo started a project in cooperation with Paradise Park to reintroduce choughs to the Channel Isles. As of last year, we know of 13 pairs breeding and building nests every year. Choughs actually have a very long association with Kent. 3 choughs appeared on the coat of arms for St. Thomas a Becket. There's a local legend that originally choughs were entirely black, but a flock of them flew down to try and help Thomas a Becket as he lay dying. They were accidentally splashed by his blood, and ever since then, their legs and their beaks have been bright red. In the reign of Henry VIII, the 3 choughs were actually added to the coat of arms for Canterbury. And if you travel around the city and the surrounding countryside, you'll see that image again and again and again. Shakespeare even mentions the choughs in Kent. There's a line in his famous play, King Lear, where he mentions choughs and jackdaws flying over the cliffs of Dover. Here at Wildwood, we're part of a long-term project to reintroduce choughs to the coastline of Kent. We currently have two adult choughs here at the park. The male was born in 2009. He's now 11 years of age. The female, a little bit younger, she was born in 2014, so she's 6 years of age. They actually came to us from Paradise Park down in Cornwall. The project is a partnership of many different groups. Although Wildwood is acting as the primary breeding location for this program, other organisations involved include Jersey Zoo, Paradise Park, and the Kent Wildlife Trust. The chubs here at Wildwood successfully raised their first babies in 2017, and they've raised chicks every year since then. So we're very proud to say that we're hoping that in the next few years we'll be able to get these beautiful and iconic birds onto the cliffs of Kent, where they haven't been seen since 1776. I hope you've enjoyed hearing a little bit about these very unusual crows, and I hope you get a chance to see the choughs when you visit us here at Wildwood.